Hi there, my name is Cal. I'm one of the Rookie Me Sports Science members and welcome to the NBL Next Gen Combine. The team here at Rookie Me performed an NBL Combine testing event that mirrors the same standards and expectations of the NBA Combine. We ran them through a testing battery that assessed their overall athleticism and allows coaches and scouts here to evaluate some of the talent here today.
Here at the anthropometric station, we measure wingspan, height and weight. There's advantages to being quite tall when playing basketball. We can obviously get closer to the ring when we're dunking, shooting, and with offensive play. And with defensive play, rebounding is obviously very important. In a game situation, it's obviously very important to have height, but wingspan is something that's not really thought of. It's actually crucial to offensive and defensive play.
Hi there, welcome to the Vertical Jump Station. Here we assess an athlete's lower leg power and their overall jumping ability. We have two tests at this station. One is a counter movement jump where their feet must be still and they're aiming to jump as high as possible. And the other one is a running jump where they can jump off 1 foot or 2 feet. This is really important for scouts and coaches to assess an athlete's verticality and in essence their shot blocking, their rebounding and overall finishing around the rim ability. In game situations, having a higher vertical leap allows you to be a better rebounder. It allows you to have a better vertical defense. You're able to get up and block shots at the rim more and protect better, and it helps for athletes in transition when they're finishing around the rim. Overall, if you have a better jump, you're going to be a better basketball player. Having a great vertical leap or having a good vertical leap can sometimes make up for discrepancies in height. This is especially important in basketball situations. If a smaller player is matched up with a bigger player, their vertical jumping ability can compensate for the lack of height or the discrepancy in height between players.
The pro-lane drill sees athletes move in a forward, sideways and backwards motion to calculate their acceleration and quickness as they change direction across multiple movement planes. This is most helpful when moving around the court in set plays and transitioning from offense to defense.
So this is the reactive pro-lane shuttle drill, which is testing an athlete's reactive agility. So the test requires the athlete to stand in the middle of the test and wait for a light to flash either left or right. They're not allowed to bounce, they have to stand perfectly still until the light flashes left or right and then they take off. Once it does, it's as quick as possible to react to that light stimulus and then complete the test in the fastest time possible. So typically those who are quicker in this reactive agility drill will be quicker to react to other stimulus during a game, which may lead to more intercepts, evading opponents, or also putting your own teammates into better positions to score, which ultimately helps overall team performance.
Here at the three-quarter court test, we test an athlete's maximum acceleration and their top court speed. It's important in this test that the athlete starts correctly and accelerates to their full capacity. This test is really important so a coach or a scout can understand how quickly a player can move up and down the court in defensive and offensive transitions.